Apple's iPhone SE has been out for about 2 weeks, and we here at MacSec have been using it and enjoying it, but there seems to be a lot of people that are disappointed with it and don't really understand why people would buy this phone. So in this video, I'm gonna share our thoughts on the iPhone SE after 2 weeks of use, as well as trying to help you guys understand why this phone is actually a really great phone for a lot of people. But before that, I want to quickly talk about the last budget phone that really impressed us. The Pixel 3a from Google. When we started using the Pixel 3a, we realized that you're getting a lot of value for your money, mainly for the excellent camera performance. But with this phone, there are a couple of downsides. First off, it featured a lower end processor, which was considerably slower than on the Pixel 3. And the second issue was that if you did buy it, it wouldn't really last you that long before having to upgrade. What I mean is that Android phones don't really get very great software support for a long time. Google themselves mandated 2 years of security updates for popular phones in the new Android contract. So after 2 years, you need to buy a new Android phone if you want to keep up to date with security features. So now let's see how the iPhone SE compares. You could also get this phone for $400, which is a very good deal. It gets incredibly good camera performance, and we know that for sure because we did a blind test comparing the iPhone SE to the iPhone XR and the iPhone 11 Pro, and in a lot of cases, it was tough to tell the difference between them. And the biggest difference between the older iPhone 8 and this iPhone SE is the latest generation of Smart HDR. This change alone makes a huge difference, as you can see in these photo comparisons, and you can tell that the background is blown out right here, but with Smart HDR, you see all of that detail, and that makes a massive difference for photo quality, and that's why the iPhone SE performs so well. And yes, it sucks that it doesn't get night mode, but that's because it doesn't have the same new sensors as the iPhone 11. But overall, you're really getting an excellent camera for the price. Now, the biggest difference between the Pixel 3a and the iPhone SE is that the SE gets the A13 Bionic chip. This is not only the best chip that Apple makes for its smartphones, but it's also the fastest smartphone chip in the world. Check out this clip from Linus Tech Tips that considers the idea of a budget Android smartphone getting the fastest available chip.
Would you guys want to see this concept repeated by Android handset makers? If Samsung was like, hey, Galaxy S7, but with a Snapdragon 865 in it, would you buy that?
Day one,
$400.
Yeah.
Now that is what adds incredible value to the iPhone SE. And don't worry, we're also gonna be comparing this phone to the Google Pixel 4a when it gets released, so make sure to hit that subscribe button down below so you don't miss out. So with the iPhone SE, you're getting the best chip available, great camera quality for the price, and don't forget that it also gets wireless charging, unlike the Pixel 3a. And those are the reasons why we think there's gonna be so many people upgrading from older iPhones like the iPhone 6, 6S, 7, and 8, to this iPhone. And not only that, but we expect a lot of people who would usually buy a budget Android phone to choose the iPhone SE instead because of those features that we mentioned. And don't just take my word for it. It's already being reported that many Android users are switching over to the iPhone SE, which is a really good sign for Apple. Now, the other reason why I think Android users are choosing to go with the iPhone SE is because instead of only getting software support for 2 years, you actually get 5 years of updates with the SE. And how do I know this? Well, iOS 13 is Apple's current software that's running on their latest iPhones. And if you take a look at the compatibility list, it actually supports the iPhone 6S, which was released in 2015. Yep, that's 5 years ago. So if you buy this iPhone SE right now, you can bet that you'll be getting the latest security updates and new features through 2025, and that's what really makes this a great choice for consumers seeking a budget smartphone. And for those people who usually just buy used phones, we believe the iPhone SE just killed the used market as well. Looking at the iPhone 8, which was priced at $700 brand new, After 2.5 years of use and being in good condition, it sells for $300. So why would you buy that instead of just paying $400 for the brand new iPhone SE that has a much better camera, processor, and a new battery that lasts even longer than on a new iPhone 8 because of the efficiency improvements that come with the A13 chip? We're talking about 20 to 25% more screen on time. So those are the reasons why the iPhone SE really makes sense to buy. And now I want to get into the things that we really enjoyed about the SE. First off, the small size really feels great in the hand, so it's really nice and compact. And the UI was incredibly quick and responsive thanks to that chip. We could play basically any game on it with maxed out graphics, but it definitely wasn't as great of an experience since the display is so much smaller than the iPhone 11 Pro Max which we're used to. The speakers sounded surprisingly good for a phone this size, and the Touch ID button was really quick and responsive, so it's great for those who don't like Face ID. Overall, it gives you a really great and reliable experience, especially thanks to iOS, which will make the iPhone SE feel quick and powerful for years. Now, of course, we don't think anyone who already has an iPhone with Face ID should downgrade because you're going back to that small square display, but we recommend anyone with a Touch ID iPhone to upgrade because of the processor, the camera, and the incredibly good price. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this review, and if you did, go ahead and tap the like button and click the circle above to subscribe so you don't miss out on more videos like this one. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.